Hi, this is Stuart from Solid Signal, and this isn't going to be our average everyday unboxing. I got one of these Magewell Ultra Stream HDMI encoders, and it's been a little bit of a challenge to unbox. I'm recording this after I've taken all the photos and the videos, so I've got some idea at this point what I'm in for, but you don't yet. Take a look and you'll see our most challenging unboxing yet. The Magewell Ultra Stream HDMI encoder is one of those devices that says it's an all-in-one. It's a little box that allows you to connect any HDMI input and, using an app to control it, stream it out over the internet or to your local network. It's designed to be easy for folks to set up and use. And yet, when I started to unbox it, I noticed something. This is a really nice quality box. You've got really kind of a nice soft, dull finish on it. It's nicely put together. I got your QR codes on the back. And yet, I tried to slide off this protective cover and, well, it just wasn't coming off, no matter what I tried. So, long story short, it was just really, really tight and it took a while to slide off. Once I did slide it off, I found the quick start guide. I found this piece of paper, which didn't actually end up doing anything. This is the unit itself, which we'll go into detail in a minute. It's got a lot of stuff going on, and I will get into close-ups. And then you've got these two boxes, which are also in, you know, really tight. Tight tolerances, I will say, although it's a sign that the product is well put together. This box itself, I'll get to that in a minute. And then there's a second box. Inside the larger of the two, you get a power cable, which looks like a USB cable, and it isn't. And you get an HDMI cable, which looks like an HDMI cable, and it is. You also get the power adapter, which comes with ends for pretty much anywhere to be used on the globe, which is a bit surprising and probably not something that our average solid signal fan is going to need, but still looks like a quality piece. What's interesting about it is that it does have a USB output, but then the power rating is 5 volts at 3 amps, which is more than you would find in any other USB-A device. Looking at the main unit, it's really intended to be an appliance. All those things at the top are indicator lights, and you've got a button to record and a button to go live. This is designed to be set up with your phone and left that way. Looking at the top panel, you've got HDMI pass-through in and out, which means you can hook up a monitor to this to see what it's doing. You've got an Ethernet connection. It does Wi-Fi and Ethernet. And of course, the power connection. The power cord's got USB on one side and this kind of standard power connection on the other. On the other side, you've got a headphone output, a microphone input, and a USB connector, not to be confused with the power connector. This USB connector is intended to let you record for posterity while you're streaming. Nice little feature. So here's really what I learned from this unboxing. It was a bit unconventional because it didn't come open as easily as I thought it would, but I'm not going to hold that against Magewell because they built a quality product and they put it in a quality box. Tolerances were extremely tight on the packaging, and that's not a bad thing. All in all, this looks like the kind of device that's going to be really appealing to, for example, churches, synagogues, mosques, that sort of thing, where you've got somebody who's not going to be the easiest and most tech-savvy person to work with. You can set this up ahead of time, push one button, and it will stream to most of your favorite platforms like YouTube and Facebook. You set it up using the app, and I'm going to do that in another video. All in all, I look forward to spending some more time with this device because it's clear that the attention to detail from Magewell is second to none. I'm very glad that they sent this to me. Oh, be sure to like and subscribe to see other unboxing videos like this.